Welcome to day two of the Warhammer TV Advent Calendar. Now, Michael Pemberton, and in fact many of you, have asked how to paint Tau armour in the classic Tau set ochre scheme. So I'm going to show you a great way to achieve that. We're going to be starting with a base coat of XV88, then we're going to do an all-over layer of Tau light ochre. And after that, we'll add some depth with an all-over shade of Agrax Earthshade. And then after that, we will brighten back up the armour with some Tau light ochre. Then finally, we'll be adding some highlights with Ungor Flesh. So, I'm going to get started. I'm going to grab my XV88 and give the pot a good shake. Just remember to keep the lid on while you do that. I'm going to grab my medium base brush because I'd like to just get it all over the model. Nice, even finish. I'm going to add some water as well so I can get a nice, smooth paint on the armour. Then when you're ready, I'm going to apply it all over the armour. Just making sure to get in all of those details. Just need to remember to have two thin coats so you get a nice solid finish without blocking up any of those details. With the base coat of XV88 now applied, the next thing we have to do is add an all-over layer of Tau light ochre. So I'm going to use my medium base brush again. I'm just going to pop some paint on the palette and add a little bit of water so it goes down nice and smoothly. And then we're just going to apply this in exactly the same way as we did the base coat. And you just want to get it all over the armour, again, in all of the details and cracks. You will need two thin layers to get a nice solid finish on this without obscuring any of that lovely detail. And with the all over layer of Tau light ochre done, it's time to add some depth to the armour by using a shade of Agrax Earthshade. I'll be using my medium shade brush to apply this because I'm going to be getting it all over the armour. I'm just going to get a good amount onto my palette so I can control how much is on my brush. You don't want too much. And then what we're going to do is just apply it all over the armour, taking care to get in all of those details. And you want to keep an eye on it as it's drying, especially on these large flat areas, just to prevent any pooling. You can remove any excess shade with your brush. And just remember to give it plenty of time to dry before you do the next step. About half an hour should be fine. With the shade now dry, you can really see that it's brought out all of those little details in the armour. And now what we've got to do next is brighten the armour back up with a layer of Tau light ochre. I'll be using my small layer brush to apply this because some of the armour is a little bit smaller, so it can be quite tricky to get. But as usual, choose the correct brush for whatever you feel comfortable with. I'm just going to add a little bit of water to my paint to make sure it goes on nice and smoothly. It's really important for this last layer. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to start on the chest where you can see there's a bit of shade there. I'm just going to neaten it back up, avoiding all of the recesses. You want to need two thin layers to get a nice solid finish on this. With the armour brightened back up, the final thing we have to do is to add a highlight with Ungor Flesh. Now I'll be using my artificer brush to apply this because I want the neatest highlights that possible. I'm going to add a little bit of water as well, just so I can get a nice smooth paint. It's really important for these edge highlights. Remember to get a nice tip on your brush. And then I'm going to start with the edge here. You can do this in a really easy way. You can just get it at about a 45 degree angle. Just run the edge of your brush along the edge, just like that. As you can see, get a really nice highlight. However, on other bits like this, you will just have to be as neat as possible. So just run it along the edge, just like that. And if you do make any mistakes, don't worry, because you can neaten back up with Tau light ochre. With the edge highlights now done, that's the Tau Breaches armour complete. And there's just a few things to remember when painting your Tau armour. When you're applying the paint, try and keep it as thin as possible so you get a lovely smooth finish and you don't obscure any detail. And also, when you're applying edge highlights, try and keep it as neat as possible for a fantastic finish. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial and we'll see you again soon for more.
If you enjoyed that tutorial and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to our YouTube channel, Warhammer TV, which is full of loads of other tutorials, but also trailers and miniature showcases too.
If you want to watch some right now, why not check out some of the videos down below?